So oftentimes I'll mark a queen so she's easy to find. But this one, I think she's been replaced this season. So I think we have a new queen here. Here's our queen. In thousands of bees, she blends in pretty good. But if you note her thorax, the middle segment, is not as fuzzy as the worker bees. There she walks right by a drone. The drone's short and fat. She's long and lean. Nice long abdomen. She's looking in a cell right now. And maybe she'll even lay an egg for us. Watch her walk past that cell. Oh, there must have been an egg in it. What she does is she'll walk up to a cell and she gauges that with her front legs. If it's a worker size cell, which most of these are, she knows to, when she backs in that cell, to fertilize the egg and produce a worker bee. If it's a drone size cell, the larger cells, which we saw on the other side, she'll lay an egg, and as it passes through her body, she doesn't fertilize it. And so a drone, that becomes a drone. It's a half a set of chromosomes. So she's actively looking for a place to lay. She's checked that cell. Some queens are really comfortable to lay an egg in the broad daylight, but a lot of them are kind of shy about it. So I wouldn't count on it. She may just not be able to find a place on this frame. She may be moving from frame to frame to look for some space. She's already filled these others up. But it's good that you can see the comparison of her and the workers. It takes years to get a real keen eye to pick a queen out of those thousands of bees. But after you get used to it, she kind of just stands out. I won't say I can always find them, but here we've gotten lucky. Found her in the top box, so we didn't have to lift all these boxes to hunt her to the bottom. So now that I've got the queen on this frame, I definitely want to be very careful. I wouldn't want to set this frame outside of the hive. When I place it, I want to know where she's at. Make sure she's not over here where the pinch points are on the frame. Make sure she's in a safe position, because you can crush a queen putting a frame back in. Make sure she's not on the bottom edge of this frame where all these little chunks of comb are, because you could crush her. If I accidentally crushed the queen, I probably wouldn't even know it, you know, putting frames back together. Within hours, every bee in this hive would know that they didn't have a queen. They would respond to that by locating several larvae in the 12-hour-old stage. It's an egg for about 2 days, falls over on its side and hatches. Once it hatches, in that first 12 hours, you get the ideal queen. They can make a queen for a couple days, 2-3-day-old larva, but the best queens happen when that larva is very young. And they would begin to elongate the cells and turn them downward. I've got this frame kind of upside down, but turn them downward and elongate and make queen cells. They'd get much bigger than that. They flood the larva with royal jelly, so the queen gets a super diet as she's being raised. And that's basically what produces a queen. Then once those queens hatch, they hunt down their sisters, because generally only one queen can prevail in the hive. They fight to the death. Whoever the queen is that wins, once she's got her strength a few days, a week later, she takes mating flights. And once she's mated and ready to lay, she saves all that sperm in her body in the spermatheca. And she'll never leave the hive again unless they swarm. So once she's mated, if she runs out of sperm, she doesn't get an opportunity to go do it again. It's a one-time deal over the course of a couple days that she mates. And then she won't leave the hive again unless they swarm.